Yeah, this is Truth Be Told, Tricky, and I'm here with the most special guy, a legendary guy, who's my guy, and been like that, and I don't even want to baby food him with, I don't want to baby food you with my guy business, because you know he's chucked around so much on the internet. This is like a real life family member.
Come on, dog.
This guy, like, who's been in the industry, and we chuck around the word legendary so much, everyone gets it. Do you get what I'm saying? But without having the full credentials of what it is to be a legend and going through what I call all the stages. And this man has, like, everything. So, yeah, let's introduce my guy.
My brother.
Coke.
Tricks, you done,
know.
You
get what I'm saying? Yeah, no, bro, you get me? Bro, we're going to speak, bro. It's a truth be told situation. So, normally, me and you, we don't talk about these things.
Nah,
we just
sure.
know what it is, so we know what it is.
For sure.
But we linked up when... It wasn't cool to link a man like me.
Yeah.
It was dangerous.
Vice versa.
Yeah, bro. It wasn't cool. And a lot of people in the industry, they're friends now because it's all cool to be friends.
Yeah.
But it was a dangerous time where, you know, you stand up with a man like me, like it's something could happen.
For sure.
Do you get what I'm saying? A man took that on the board, and you know, with me, I always had that in the back of my head, like, nah. These man done it at dangerous times.
Yeah, but
so they wore their heart on their sleeve.
You know, man was going through the same stuff as well.
Bro, I said that to a man, and I thought, you know what? I said that to a man earlier. I goes, you know what?
As dangerous as it was for me, it's the same thing for you. You get what I'm saying, blood?
I said that to a man earlier. I goes, they probably thought, you know what? This extra man on me don't make no difference. It don't make no difference. We're from that world. Like, love is love. Who I love and who I rock with is a man never hid it from. Man used to come in our videos, bro, and put on mask when it wasn't even coronavirus. Yeah, just to hide their face. You know what I'm saying? I know how it was. Like, so for man to stand up in videos and you French, you know, obviously, like, enough love, big up my guy French straight away. And it's just been nothing but love straight from that. It's been no Instagram love. It's been no stupid, like, affections. It's been totally real.
Facts.
You get me? Facts. Not none of that. And I know certain times, I'm going to be honest, I know certain times, even within this industry, you might have been mad with me. I'm seeing me on doing top fives and thinking, "Rah, how come Tricky ain't saying my name?" Do you get what I'm saying?
A banger man, I can name, but
yeah,
I'm not gonna do that.
Trust me, it happens, bro. It happens. But yeah, on our connection and how it was made, it was come from a real street level when there was nothing involved.
Come
there
on.
Weren't not a penny exchanged, like just real street love. And I always like to say that because I tell man, this is why a lot of rappers in this industry now, I feel this is why their relationships come and go so easy now.
Right.
You see man rolling one day and then they're not rolling the next day because it's built off of the check. And if the check don't come, we might as well split up.
That's why I miss the don't F with nobody. Do you get me? I've always just kept myself to myself because I'm not into the fake relationships. And the reason why I'm here with you now is because you've always kept it 100 with man. You get what I'm saying? I wouldn't be having this conversation with anyone else.
Yeah,
you feel me?
Like, yeah.
So yeah, you done know, man.
No, 100%, bro. 100%. It ain't come from nowhere. So us feeling like that has brought us to here. And how the Hackney and Stonebridge connection was made through us. And I've had nothing but love from everyone that has ever come. Anyone that's come near you, without you even saying, you know what, show him love, they've just shown love.
No, come on.
You get
man.
Me? Because they know what it is. Do you get what I'm saying? I'm not afraid to tell man, like, I've gone in Stonebridge with just me and Marks. Two men.
Yeah.
Dangerous city. Yeah. You get what I'm saying? But comfortable because I know who I'm with.
Facts.
Do you get what I'm saying? And man have made me feel comfortable, bro. And I promise you, and I say that because...
And vice versa, though. Man's come to feel to meet the man
100%,
there, man. It's the same
100%.
Thing, you know what I'm saying?
And I wouldn't do that in so many places because, you know, everyone's certified. But a man will take you to his block and get you beat up because the other certified man don't like you, like.
Yeah, facts.
And he's overpowering him. So I've seen you recognize... The same thing goes in it. Real recognize real. And the moment I knew that this guy is the true one... When I saw you on Are You Alone?
Yeah.
And I say, once you see a man standing in front of 40 black men, heavy as hell, and man really patting the chest saying, this is the guy.
Yeah.
And then when you go into certain things and you might ask certain people, not just like to dig in the business, work on for, I got my guy over there. And every time it comes back,
But you see them
he's
times
a real
there,
one. He's a real
but
one.
But them times
one.
There, yeah. It was that. Like, you couldn't just rap. Like, no one didn't even care if he was a good rapper.
Yeah.
Like, man wanted to know, what does was this, on? Is this guy really live what he's talking about? Do you get what I'm saying? And that's probably the main reason why man like us flourished in those times. Because when you did your research, man was really those guys.
Yeah,
it all checked out.
100%.
Now it's different, you get me? You could put on a mask, say whatever, and no one don't know what's happening.
And even
you know
if nothing checks out, I've noticed.
Yeah.
If you got the money, man would just say, but he's lit
he's
though.
Lit, yeah,
he's got, doing his thing though. I'm asking about his realness, like, where's he coming from? But what's his credentials like? I saw you from then and I thought, you know what? Real one. From then, it was just dopeness from that.
Respect,
you get what I'm saying? So you take man from that moment.
So obviously I've done Are You Alone, fam. What was that, like 2009, I think it was?
Was it?
I think it was right, 2009. Mm. Obviously after that, the roads was just on, man, after that. Done the fire in the booth with Charlie because of the whole background and that. And then, it just went off after that, innit?
Oh. Literally. I had a couple of men in here saying that was the hardest one ever. Yeah.
You know, it was a different time then as well. I didn't go in there and think about it. It weren't like, oh, I'm going to do a fire in the booth. I need to write these bars.
I
just went in there. I was all half liquored when I got in there. I just had fun with it. You get what I'm saying, bro? It was just one of those moments still. And then obviously the Jay-Z thing came through and it kind of made more sense to me because it was unheard of before. So for man doing rap, like what? The Americans are fucking with man and they want to do this with man, yeah? Mm. Cool, like. It just made sense, you get me? And that's where we went.
And from there, what I saw there is what we was talking about just before and about juggling both.
Yeah.
That people just see the record deal.
Yeah,
but
you don't know,
after man's coming out of Kensington and going to the meeting, he's back on the
back
block.
Back on the block.
Do you get what I'm saying? Yeah, like, facts around all these other animals, like, do you get
facts,
what I'm saying?
Facts.
And it's a record deal to me, but to these other animals, it's a way out.
Yeah.
It's a way out, so they're seeing me as the savior for this city, do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
And I don't know if it was when you got the record deal or just after that you went to the Bing.
Yeah, it was like 4 months later.
Yeah.
So I signed in, 2010? I signed 2 days before Christmas. And then a week later, I went to Toronto, innit? I had some shows in Toronto and that. So I went to Toronto, but we didn't tell no one I got signed until I got back.
Mm.
And then, got back, told everyone in January, boom, boom. Everything looked like it was about to go.
You
get me? And then, boom.
But it's what we was talking about, bro, about doing both.
Yeah.
And how hard it is and letting people know that, because you know, everyone will just say it, bro. Let's just talk, truth be told, innit? People will just come out and say like, oh, so he got a record deal and did it. What happened with it? They're not seeing what's behind the scenes.
Nah,
man was
sure.
really in the field,
nah, for
bro.
Sure. But there's a
saying?
Lot of things that man can't even talk in and don't even care what people think or know. Do you know what I'm saying? Because man's really going through it.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
So who cares about what some other guy thinks? Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
When man's really out here in the dungeon. Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, bro.
So yeah. Obviously, April the 1st, I got nicked for the attempted murder. Mm. And I've gone to sit down, innit?
Yeah, but it must have.
And wait for trial.
And I'm not gonna lie. Usually, I'll let you baby food it and just say, "Man, went to sit down." But it couldn't mentally, bro. And this is why I do these things and I have these conversations because mentally, it couldn't have been that easy.
What for sure?
Mentally, not. I've left all of that out
for
there.
For sure, blood. I've expressed that way more than enough times. I'm not gonna sit here and shoot. I've been jail bare times. Mm. That time was the hardest time.
Of course.
Because now I've got. And it's not so much about being in jail, cause I'm in jail. And when I go to jail, everyone knows man and rates man and respects man. I only have problems with people I have problems with.
It's like a home away from home.
Do you know what I'm saying? So and blood, when I've gone there, the love is exceptional. Like they cannot even screws, they can't even believe man's in it.
Yeah.
They're letting man out and you get me? They want autographs for their kids and do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it's love, but I've got all of this going on outside. Outside, you get me? Yeah. This is an opportunity that can possibly change mine and my family's life forever. You get what I'm saying? So, of course, it weighs heavy on man. You get me? I'm stressed. I want to go home.
Yeah, 100%. 100%. Because there's times when I've been in a Bing, bro, and there's times when man don't care about going home or not. Do you get what I'm saying? Man's here. Like,
I'm here. I know I'm going home soon.
I was there at 17, bro. It was a field day. All the man them's here. And then, as I said, it was a home away from home.
Yeah.
But I knew that time, that's when it's playing on his head.
Facts.
That's when it's like, bro, this has just gone on.
Facts. But and so much because it's something I didn't do made it 10 times worse as well. Yeah, yeah. You get what I'm saying? Yeah, like, literally. Bro. Like, going to jail for something you did, you're like, all right, cool, I fucked up.
We put our hands up from it, we're in the police station.
I fucked up, you get me?
Yeah.
But this time, it's got nothing to do with me. And I'm feeling like the feds know it as well, do you get me? But it's like, they're really trying to, you know what I'm saying?
Because, bro, I'm not going to lie, you was one of the, and I know, you know everyone's going to do their homework when I say this and bring up a old school rapper that got signed, but from the streets that we know, bro.
Yeah, yeah.
One of the first man from the streets from our world, because we're all north, south, east, west, we're all the same.
Fact.
Like, the first man that we knew from the streets to get a deal was you.
Fact.
Do you get what I'm saying? We didn't see no one else. So it was like, bruh. Like, do you get what I'm saying? Like, how did he do this?
I think even the feds, they just didn't like that as well, man. They was trying to hold that back as much as possible. Do you get what I'm saying? I kind of felt like that as well, man.
One thing I will say, see, when you're real, the feds know it.
Yeah,
because I can sit down with her.
Blood, I've been nicked for multiple crazy stuff.
Yeah,
you get me. Yeah. They know. Yeah. They know that man's out here in the streets, so they're not happy to see this stuff going on. They're thinking, I don't know. For me, we're trying to change our life around. Yeah. They probably think we're trying to buy earners for the hood and that. You get?
Yeah, 100%. That's what they think, and they. I'm not gonna lie. I remember. An officer came to me in Hypes one time after a video shoot, and the one thing that he said stuck with me. He was like, "Do you lot think you're gonna do all this madness and roll off into the sunset?" I promise you, an officer, Trident officer.
Yeah.
We used to call him Shaky Mike.
Yeah.
Because when he used to come around, man, he used to shake. Like, do you get what I'm saying? He's nervous, bro. Because they're like, but as I said, they know who's a pumpkin and who's not.
Yeah,
they know who's baby food and who's not.
Yeah, yeah.
So they're thinking, you know what? This is a very serious man. We can't let him just roll off like this after he's caused hell here.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm saying? He can't just roll off to the sunset.
Yeah,
and then they're seeing you in video, you got a smile.
Mm.
We got to nick him for something to derail the train that's pushing forward.
Fact.
Do you get what I'm saying?
Fact.
And after that, the prison sentence and the record deal, like mentally, where was you?
Fuck.
Yeah.
I was missing. Not missing, but... Obviously, after I caught another case.
Yeah.
Like, I had the birthday party. So, obviously, when I've come out, they've decided they're Rock Nation and that's deciding they're going to keep man on, innit? Mm. But Sony weren't so sure because obviously they've never had a gangster rapper before in their whole thing. They don't know what's
stealing.
Going on.
They're stealing.
Yeah, do you get what I'm saying? But, so, they don't even know what's going on. But Ty was took me back in there. Was like, listen, if you're not gonna keep him, I'm just gonna take him to Universal. Or, so then they was like, all right, cool, we'll make it work. But it's single. But while all that's going on, the feds they're phoning the label. Oh. Like, facts, they're phoning the label. Like, yo, like, do you know what you lot are doing? Do you know who this guy is? Do you know? And then they're stopping every show. They're threatening promoters. Like, if you make this guy perform, we're gonna take your license. We won't police your event. Like, they've gone to crazy extent to stop me from doing what I'm doing. Do you get what I'm saying? Mm. Obviously, it's not really an excuse, but it's disheartening after a while. Do you
it's
know when you're
excuse,
when,
bro,
when you're jumping hurdles, and they just keep throwing them up? You're like, you get me? What is it going to take? You know what I'm saying, bro?
Yeah.
And then, obviously, the birthday party happened. Feds came. They actually beat me up on the spot, done me for assault. So I've caught another case now. Do you get what I'm saying? And then, that was when the whole thing went sour and kind of the label situation fell. Do you get me?
Mm.
And after that, I was just like, fuck it, man. This is long. I got another case. I might be going back to jail soon. It's like, fuck music. Is this shit even worth it? Do you know what I'm saying, bro? And I was genuinely in that headspace for a little while. You know what I'm saying?
Mm. But it's good to even say that, bro, because like, people always just think about the plain and simple thing.
Mm.
Why ain't he doing music? And you're thinking, that's the last thing on my head.
Bro, I might be going to jail. I might be going back to jail soon. You know what I'm saying, bro?
But it's good to let people know. And another thing that I would like to even point out, bro, because I've said it for time. You see these industry folk.
Yeah.
And you see these labels.
Yeah.
If they knew how to deal with the real ones, they wouldn't have even shied away from that problem. They would have just, and in America, they deal with it.
Yeah, yeah.
Because they know how to deal with real ones.
If man was in America, it would be a whole
baby
different
food.
Story.
Oh, well, he's got 3 a.m. charges. Oh, that's nothing.
But you have to remember, this we're like a little bit behind in that,
very
in
much
that
behind.
Section.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? Yeah. So when I've come up, there's no blueprint. There's no, there's no thing. Man's literally laying the steps as I'm going. Do you know what I'm saying? There's nothing to follow or no one to give advice or help you in those situations.
Yeah, yeah.
Every time the feds are troubling me, all everyone's telling me is just leave it. Don't say nothing because it's going to get worse.
Yeah.
What do you mean? I can't, that's not who I am. Yeah, just sit down and finger. So even that's fucking with me mentally. Mm. Do you get me? Because I'm not the kind of person to just take things and don't say nothing. Mm. Feds or no feds, like. Yeah. If it's on my chest, I'm gonna talk. You know what I'm saying, bro? Yeah. That's just who I am.
Yeah.
So yeah, you know how it goes, man. You get me.
So what were the, like, I would say, like, what were the biggest regrets, for all of that?
I think my biggest regret was probably taking that break and not carrying on and being consistent. Do you get me? That's probably my biggest regret.
Same as me, bro. Facts, same as me. Facts. Yeah, and you think, you know what?
Because I know if I persevered, I'd probably be gone clear already again.
But bro, I'm not going to lie. I'm not going to even put you in that category because you know what no one's going to be able to really understand? No one was there at that time but you.
Yeah.
So there, even when you look back certain times, you say, you know what? I wish I went through that. When you really check it, I would have never went through that. Yeah, do you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Because of the headspace how you was in, because of the way things went, when people say, you know what, oh, with the mash tan thing and bro, man was leaving video shoots, getting stopped for burners and getting this and money charges and everything. And I know if I put myself back, would I have really changed anything? And I doubt I would have. Nah, I'm not even gonna stunt to myself. Do you get me?
It is what it is, do you get what I'm saying? And everything happens for a reason, bro. But if one of my regrets would be just to carry on, you get me? Rather than take that little breakaway, but at the same time, I needed it. I needed to just kick back and get my head right because I'm mentally not feeling all right. Do you get what I'm saying? I'm dealing with so much that I can't be focused on music. Do you get what I'm saying? I got way more other stuff
Did that totally put you off music?
Literally, yeah. Mm. It was a bad experience. Do you get me? Yeah, so now where man's come up having that love for music and doing it for fun, it's not that anymore. Mm. You know what I'm saying? Like, now I don't even like what music comes with. I don't like the attention. I don't like being in the limelight.
I know you don't.
I don't like all of that. But obviously, I love doing music, and I love that people love my music. Yeah. But the rest of the stuff that it comes with, it's not for me. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
I always look at you and I say, you know what? I know Coke. If Coke can just release shit without doing no videos and really take it somewhere, he'll just be releasing and not.
I've been thinking about doing that lately as well. Do you get me? But obviously, I found a new love and a new passion for it again. Do you get what I'm saying? I'm having fun with it again, which is everything for me. Saying?
But to actually stay on them times, what were the, you said about the prison.
Yeah.
What were the most darkest times, bro? Like the darker times.
Well, obviously.
Like of the music and the label and the prison and this, that, and the other.
It's the fake love that comes with the attention. You know, like when you're in those predicaments and everyone's around you showing love, for me anyway, I took that as it's actually love. Do you get what I'm saying? So when obviously things start to take a left and I was just sitting there watching, man, fall. So now, I mean, I want to take this to the, as far as it can go. Mm. And I want to see who's really going to stay around. Like, who's really here for Coke? You get me? Who's really here for man?
Mm.
And I just sat down and I was watching people fall. And I was just like, raw, this is mad, bro. Mm. You get me? Like, just watching people. And then now the same people that used to link me every day in my yard, brother this, brother that. People I couldn't get rid of, people that don't phone my phone, also, I can't even get a call back. Oh, you get what I'm saying? So it's those things that made me just say, you know what, fuck this shit, it's dead. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, no, man. It's.
But obviously, jail was a dark time as well. I missed my daughter's birth. I got into an altercation in there, got slapped and that. Do you get what I'm saying? So it was all a dark time, do you know what I'm saying? Plus all of the other shit that's going on, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, because the whole, even the daughter thing, bro, I know you wear your heart on your sleeve like myself.
Facts.
So people will be thinking, oh, this, that, and the other. And the one thing you got on your mind is, I just want to go home to my youth.
My daughter's about to be born, bruv. Yeah. And I'm stuck here. I'm going court every day.
Mm.
My solicitor's having to sneak in pictures of my daughter when she's born, the day I'm on court. You get what I'm saying? Like, she's born today.
And I'm sitting in there, man.
In the courtroom, like, looking like, rah, my daughter, I'm not even there.
Yeah,
you get me. I'm here fighting this case.
Because we're out here thinking, where's Pure Coke 5? Like, do you get me?
You
thinking, fuck Pure Coke, bro. Yeah. I want to see my youth.
Yeah,
like,
I can't give a fuck.
Do you get what I'm saying?
Music right now.
Yeah, 100%.
I'm looking at a 15. You get what I'm saying? I'm looking at 15 years behind the door. You think I'm?
Yeah.
I'm looking at my daughter's picture in a fucking court cell, bro. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but that's the realness of it, bro. That's the realness. That's the realness, man. And it plays with your mental. Do you get what I'm saying? Yeah. It messes with your mental.
Like, I've anyone that tells it. You it doesn't is lying.
I've been through it, and not and why I know it's hurt, and I treat it like I'm not trying to baby food myself, but I know because you reach the higher level, you felt it more. The higher you go, the more you feel it. Fact. Because you got so much attention. People want to speak to you about things that on that day I just don't want to speak about. Do you get what I'm saying? And you're thinking I'm rude or but nah, bro, don't come and ask me about some when's music being released. Yeah. When am I being released?
You know what I'm saying, blood?
Do you get what I'm saying? So I get it, and I know that, but I always like to touch on and say, like, because I know, bro, you see, especially for guys like us from the streets, bro, we mentally go through it.
Mentally, bro.
And I'll talk about myself without even pushing too much on you, bro. I mentally had to get away from, because you know them thoughts every day. It's just that the people don't understand it. And why they don't understand it, I get it. I get why they don't understand it. You never lived that life.
You never lived that life.
So I can really get why your mind is free and clear every day to go studio whenever you want.
Yeah.
7 days a week.
Yeah.
Not one day off in 10 years.
Yeah.
Do you get me?
Yeah, I get it.
I get it. I don't baby food you. But don't talk on us when we might have a time off and da-da-da. Because when people have time off, bro, I check them and I'm like when you was, I'm saying, you know what? I know this guy.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm saying? So I know.
I needed it, bro.
Mentally, it's bigger than. Yeah,
bro. Needed it.
You needed it.
Yeah.
Of course you did. Of course you did. Okay. I know you did, bro. I know you did.
Yeah.
As me knowing you, I know you did. Because even seeing you now, like, do you get what I'm saying? I know that you needed that time to just. I don't know what it done, but I want you to explain to me.
But it was just like, obviously, like I said, I needed to change my circle a touch. Like, I needed, because I had a lot of negative people around me at the time, and you know what I'm saying, feeding off my energy and that, and then I needed to rebuild that. You get what I'm saying? My whole foundation was kind of effed from the start.
I'm gonna make a point before you go on. I'm gonna make a point before you go on, and just quickly, just because I always like to make a point and have a little lesson in there. The man that you need on the street is not the man you need in the studio.
No.
But we always get that mixed up.
Yeah.
So you understand what I'm saying?
My dogs are my dogs. The people I grew up with are the 100%. People I grew up with. And then I have my select few. But you know when you're from the street, them man, they got a couple of virgins. And them man, they got a couple of virgins. And then, and now before you know it, you got a bag of man around you. Like, cool, these man are my dogs. But
and you only know the first
these,
five.
Who are these other man? You know what I'm saying? But they're there anyway. Do you know what I'm saying? And I had to change all of that, dog. I had to sort myself out. Do you know what I'm saying? Put the right people around me. Gather my thoughts. Rebuild myself back again. Into a space where I'm comfortable now. Do you know what I'm saying? And I'm back where I need to be.
And you see, whilst you was in jail, the whole scene was blowing up.
Yeah,
the whole scene. How did you feel about that? Honestly, bro.
It was. I was pissed.
And you're not a hater.
I'm pissed, but I was pissed.
I'm pissed.
I'm sitting there. I'm big up Wretch, but I'm in there watching Wretch on T4 killing the place down. And I'm like, raw, that should be me.
You get
what I'm saying? Big, I like Wretch. You get me? And he's sick, but I'm thinking that should be me. These times I'm doing the whole thing with Rita and that, like the music stuff.
Yeah.
And she wasn't as big as me before I went to jail. Then I've gone jail. I'm watching her blowing up. Yeah, I'm just thinking, nah, this is nuts, bro. Yeah. You get me? Obviously, it's pissed. It's not good to see. I should be out there doing that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
So you must have seen it as like, well, not seen it as these man need to be saying my name, but come on, as I said, I put myself in there, bro. Certain times, raw, like my man knows me. He knows me.
Facts. I've seen couple things that I've been watching, man, and I'm hearing man's top fives and who made an impact in the UK. And I'm like, raw, like, what did you not forget the Coke wave? Did you not forget that little error? Did man forget that little error when it was just me? Because I remember it when it was just me. You get what I'm saying? But has everyone just forgot?
I do.
Because I remember when everyone was on my nuts, bro. Do you get what I'm saying? And now I'm looking and I'm cooling and I'm thinking, bro, what? You lot forgot Coke, yeah?
Yeah.
Because you lot didn't forget Coke then. You get what I'm saying? But nah, I've been away for a bit. You lot forgot Coke, yeah?
But bro, let me tell you, why it's no disrespect, out of sight, out of mind.
Nah, I hear that. I hear that. And I'm not one to hold feelings either. Never, I just crack on with what I'm doing.
Yeah, of course.
But obviously, man's going to sit there and watch that and think, raw, is that what you
want? I'm your guy. And you don't even. I think we had one discussion. You was like, tricky, what? No top five? No? All right,
yeah,
cool, bro.
Say that.
Like, yeah.
Margs as well. Same thing. I remember Margs was in the studio. I was his favorite rapper at one stage. Well, you forgot Coke as well, dog.
Yeah, fix up, where?
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, no, man. 100%.
It is, man. I get it as well. Same time, outside, out of mind. It's like it goes. But you can't forget an error. You get what I'm saying? Yeah. I had an error. It was my thing for a good 4 or 5 years. I remember that.
Everyone remembers that. Yeah, everyone remembers
everyone it. Everyone remembers that. It was a cult wave.
Yeah.
Toronto remember that. So how's man forgot Are You Alone? Pure Cult Volume 1. Yeah. Fire in the Booth. Jay-Z coming. How have you lot all forgot that? Yeah. What's happened? Like, what is it? Like, why have you lot forgot? How can you forget a whole error?
Because we're fickle,
whether
bro.
I'm in mind or out of mind, how have you forgot a whole error?
Because we're fickle.
A whole 5 years?
We're fickle.
Come on,
and,
man.
And don't you notice I'm saying we're?
Yeah.
Because I mean, I'm with you guys. I'm an Egypt just like you. Like, you get me? We're fickle, bro.
It's disrespectful.
Yeah,
No offense taken from anyone, but like, for the work I put in, for the slabs I've laid down for everyone else to come through and do this thing here, how dare you lot forget, man? Mm. You get what I'm saying?
And I won't even put that on the younger generation coming up.
No, no.
Because you lot don't know me. It's for us, me and the others, to let them know about this guy.
Everyone knows. You get what I'm saying? Even certain of the younger generation know. You get what I'm saying? So there's no reason why... And I've seen, it's not just... It's everywhere. Like, I've noticed everyone
forgot. So even you sitting there right now, you feel underappreciated by the music scene?
I feel underappreciated, of course. Mm. Come on. Do you feel like I've been underappreciated?
100%. I've underappreciated you, bro.
All right, then. So of course I'm going to feel like that.
Yeah, 100%. 100%. And I wouldn't say underappreciated.
Like I said, it's not a feelings thing. Like, I don't hold nothing against no one. Do you know what I'm saying? I don't have no feelings for no one. Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'm just cracking on and doing what I'm doing as a man. Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I believe that the fans know what I've gone. Mm. Do you get what I'm saying? And that moment in time, you can't forget that. You can't let that go. Do you get what I'm saying?
Mm.
When you go back in history, that's going to be there forever.
Always,
do you know what I'm saying?
Always.
And I'm going to continue to persevere and win. Do you get what I'm saying? Mm. But obviously, I want to know what man's saying. Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
How have you not forgot Coke?
No, 100%, bro. That's why you have to say it, because you see what it is. You're very humble like that. You see, if I had what you had on record, man will be hearing about it every day, every caption.
I guess I probably feel to myself that I haven't achieved what I was supposed to achieve. So I ain't really got the right to be out here chatting shit.
No, but for me, that's for you personally.
I'm that competitive and I'm that in myself. I feel like I never done what I was supposed to do. You get what I'm saying? For me.
Mm.
Like, so I don't look at it like I'm out here and I deserve all of this and that.
Mm.
I'm just me, innit? You know what I'm saying? I wanted better for myself. You know what I'm saying? Given the circumstances and what I've gone through, I still wanted better. Do you get me? I still should have done more. That's me, though. Do you get what I'm saying? So I'm not out here chatting off my mouth or going in like, and I don't need anyone to tell me who I am. Do you know what I'm saying?
Do you feel that the industry blocked you in a certain way?
100%.
Because I'm telling you,
100%.
Yeah, they're real fuckboys in the industry, bro.
100 million percent.
Seen it with my own eyes.
I've watched a bag of man jump from this man to that man to this man to that man. I've watched it myself.
The A&Rs, the managers.
I've watched it. So it doesn't matter how hard, like, whoever's popping at the time is where everybody runs.
That's where they run to, yeah.
And everyone, it's just life. It's just how it goes. Do you get what I'm saying? It's just how it is.
Sad but true.
It's just the game, isn't it?
Yeah,
it's the rap industry.
Yeah.
It's the music industry in general.
Because I always tell man, bro.
Labels pick up artists and drop them like it's nothing every day. The fans do it.
Yeah.
The people involved, rappers do it.
Yeah.
Everyone does
it.
That's just how it goes.
That's why I don't have too many rap relationships. I never have. No, I never have, bro. I'm not going to lie, though. The first man, one of the first man to put me on a track and make me do a video with it, invite me to a show, even though we didn't even perform that night, but invite me down to a show and say, Tricky, come, you might be able to perform, was you, bro. Like, do you get what I'm saying? And that was years ago.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? First man, and no one's ever done it. Because I've always understand, I'll keep telling guys, I've dealt with murderers better than I've dealt with industry, right, man.
And
these men are honest.
And that might be one of my issues as well, because you see me, where I just deal with relationships. You get what I'm saying? If I rock with you, I rock with you. You get what I'm saying? I don't care if you're big, if you're small. Like, if you're my dog, you're my dog. I don't jump on everyone's bandwagon. Mm. I'm not that
Same
guy. I've
Same
never
me.
Been that guy.
Same
so
as me.
Maybe that's one of the reasons why people are like, ooh, with Coke. You get what I'm saying? Because I'm not licking your balls. Do you know what I'm saying, bro? Like, I'm just here doing my thing. You get me? Big up and that. You get me? If you want to work and you're reaching out, then we work. But I'm not begging no one nothing. Do you get what I'm saying? Like, I'm just doing my thing. And I've always done that. You get me? From the start. No one can't deny that.
No, 100%, 100%. You've kept it so thorough, even so thorough to where remember, people hate what they don't understand.
Yeah, facts.
Do you get what I'm saying? They think they love me because they think, oh, Tricky, smiley picture, oh, nice captions, I kind of get you, Tricky. I understand you. The more I've been open and honest about who I am and where I'm coming from, they love me more.
Yeah.
You're a closed book.
So
people hate what, Nas said it, bro. People hate what they don't understand and fear what they can't conquer.
Yeah, I know that.
So they hate you and they fear you.
Do you get
what I'm saying? And not because of you as a person. I just want you to, if you just come out and open up and say, you know what, which you're never going to do because it's not your character, really and truly. This is as open as I've heard
this
you.
This is.
Me and you ain't even had these conversations on the phone. We've had a lot of conversations. We don't have these conversations.
I ain't had this conversation with no one. You get me?
No,
like,
come on, bro.
Obviously, my guys and that, we all know what it is, but they feel like how I feel anyway. Yeah. They're the ones that see my ears. Like, what, Coke?
My man's an agent.
What did they all forget? I'm like, fuck that. Don't worry about that. You get me? But yeah, I don't talk. I don't need to. I feel like I don't need to too much. You know what I'm saying? Mm. I'm just having this conversation because it's huge. You get what I'm saying?
No, come on, bro. Keep saying it.
You feel me?
Let them know, bro. It's special business. You get what I'm saying? So, what do you feel right now is wrong with the UK rap scene? Because I know you don't really care. Because I know you're back right now doing your thing.
Mm.
And I've heard you, bro. We spoke on the phone. And even when I heard you with your utes the other day, bro, I'm saying, yeah, this guy's in a good place.
Yeah.
I can hear he's in a good place. And I can feel he's in a good place.
Yo, family. I'm there with the missus and my daughter. Yeah. That's boom. Music's all right. I'm comfortable now. I've got a case pending. I'm still on tag right now as we speak. God knows what's going to happen. But I'm way more comfortable now.
Because I remember kind of when it happened and I thought, because I've always thought, bro, this guy's like me. He wears his heart on his sleeve.
Yeah.
And I'll put myself out there first.
Yeah.
I went through heartbreak with a gal, bro.
Yeah.
And I couldn't even record.
Yeah.
Man was like, where's for the culture? I was like, fuck that.
Facts. Me and my missus have been off and on. And when it don't work out, I'm distraught.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? That's my family. Bro. I'm getting old, bro. I want to be with my family. Do you know what I'm saying, bro?
Yeah.
That's what means most important to me. Mm. Waking up with my daughter in the morning. Do you know what I'm saying? Come on,
bro. I tell you, bro, I'm so glad you said that.
Come on, bro.
Because one of the things that I don't even, no disrespect, I love my baby mums to bits, but I didn't want my baby mums.
Yeah,
I just wanted to wake up with my youth, bro.
Yeah.
It's powerful.
Yeah.
You feel powerful on a Sunday when, you get what I'm saying? You're back to watch football at 4 o'clock. The youths are jumping over you at 12. You know what I'm saying?
Daughter's waking me up every morning. I love that shit. That's
where I feel your energy's come from now.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm saying? That's your main thing. The main thing ain't the man, then the main thing ain't the music. Once my youth's all right and my missus all right and the family's all right, I can give you the best music of my life.
Yeah, facts.
Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah, facts, because everything else is covered. You get what I'm saying? Yeah.
That's why the Daily Duffy's cold. Do you get what I'm saying? Wife is happy, bro.
Come on.
Do you get what I'm saying? Yeah, I get that, man.
Mm.
But, you see, let's say, with all the... We're in a new era now, and you're not used to this new era. I'm getting better with it, but I know you're far behind me because you don't really deal with the, you post and go.
Yeah.
You don't really deal with the internet and or the live videos. I know you don't deal with it. And it's probably because of all the draw rats and How do you deal with that, bro?
I don't.
Yeah.
That's
gang
how I deal
shit,
with it.
Gang shit.
Yeah, I don't. Actually, I don't.
Just in person. Don't touch me or put your hands in my pocket.
Yeah.
You know the rules.
Yeah. Well, if we got an issue and we see each other, we're going to do whatever we're doing. But other than that, I ain't got time for back and forth on the internet and doing all of that. Mm. I've indulged here and there a couple of times when it's, you know what I'm saying? But that's not my style. It's not who I am. That's not how I grew. That's not what man came up off.
Mm.
You get what I'm saying? I came up off the road. When you see man, it is what it is. You know what I'm saying, bro?
That's what I stand on, bro. I think I've replied, not even in a violent way, but just replied to man before.
Yeah, I've done it before as well, but it's just not.
I feel awkward.
Yeah.
Because I feel, you know what? I actually want to smash your face.
Yeah. Talking out on the internet is not helping me. It's making me worse.
It's making me worse, bro. Where is this coming from? But I'm not going to lie to you, bro. Even with that, I'm going to keep doing it because anytime I don't want you to think, well, Tricky leading me down a garden path and not drawing himself out. Because we know what draw rats we have to stay from. We've come from road and we've come from some different sort of dramas.
Yeah.
To where we come from so much different sort of dramas that the internet part of the dramas, yeah, is baby food to me.
Yeah.
You know a man saying, oh, bro, you're idiot. Oh, watch what I catch. All right, bruv. Like, do you get what I'm saying? I've had some of the realest man tell me that when they're going to catch
me. Yeah.
Do you get what I'm saying?
My whole career has been that. Do you get what I'm saying? Man see me and don't say nothing.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm saying?
Mm. 100%, that's
I don't watch those things. You could talk what you're talking, but when we see each other, how it goes is going to be a whole different situation.
It's going to be a whole different, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, 100%.
I'm not with all of 100%. That back and forth bullshit, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, no, but bro, you know what it is? You've kept your, and this is why a lot of people have stayed with you, because you've kept your morals.
Yeah.
You can see that a man's kept his morals.
I'm a man of principles.
He's a man of principles. So to talk about myself first, you know me from the get-go, so you know where I've come from. You know I've had dramas with serious men out there, bro.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm saying? And even now, there's some guys that we can't speak.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm saying?
Same.
We could, no, 100%. I keep saying it. I'm going to keep saying it to you. I'm not leading you down the garden path. There's some man that we can't speak, but there's other men that are, so to speak, all right, cool. The truth be told, let me put it out there. I made contact with Stitcher.
Yeah.
Yeah, I made contact with him. We came from Jamaica. I was on a flight from Jamaica. I was with my sister and this, that, and the other. And Stitcher was on the flight. Do you get what I'm saying? As you're smiling, what else can we do? this ain't no, I'm not going to do the heady and tea on joint. Like, you get me? Because even with them, I'm going to say, I think they noticed they was on a fucking plane.
Yeah.
Because I noticed I was in an airport.
Yeah. Yeah.
He noticed he was in an airport.
Yeah.
So my point being to that is that's what I thought, you know what, let me reach out to you and see if we can have this conversation up front. And I'm not trying to, I keep saying it to you, bro. You're going to think, why should you keep saying this to me? I'm not trying to lead you down a garden path. But you see this whole, and I'm not going to mention a name, bro, but the whole Stonebridge and Church Road thing, it's like, it's more bigger than you.
Yeah, way
do you
bigger
get what
than
I mean? Nah, it's more bigger than you. So I'm not going to sit here and baby food you, bro. You're my guy. Like, do you get what I'm saying? So I'm not going to baby food you and say, you know what? What they will ask you probably at a capital, do you think it could ever be squashed? And No. I'm talking overall. I'm not talking you and a personal man. I'm talking overall.
I doubt it.
No, you doubt it for now.
Yeah, that, bro, people are dying. People are dead. You get what I'm saying? And it's still active, like.
But bro, that's the only thing. They catch me. That's the only thing. And I see you take a huff and a lump in the throat. Cool. Like, that's the only thing that wouldn't make me pressure this situation.
Yeah.
Do you know why? Because man have died, R1, man have died on our behalf and this, that, and the other. But I wouldn't sit here and lie to you and say it's still majorly active.
Mm.
Do you get what I'm saying? Yeah. I've got man I'd never speak to in my life.
Yeah, yeah.
I've got man if I see today, then it might be curtains for either of us.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, and I'm just saying it because I'm taking that foot.
Mm.
Not to squash it with certain man, but as a borough. As I said, I spoke to Abra. Abra's my guy. And Abra's from there. And Abra's supposed to be coming at me in a certain way, but he ain't. Do you get what I'm saying? Because he's respected, you know what?
Nah, but you know what it is? It's not so much like, I know big man down there. Mm. I don't have an issue with anyone that's from down there. I got issue with anyone that's got an issue with me.
Mm.
Facts. Like if I see a man and it's not that and he's cool, then we're cool. We don't have an issue.
Mm.
But if I see it, like, do you know what I'm saying? Mm. I know who's on what, like who's on me, who's not on me. You know when you see a man, how his facial,
I'm not
going to
baby food you.
You know
I know. I know, and I'll let them know. Because everyone's like, oh, industry and Instagram-wise. I know you've seen people that people think this is supposed to happen to you, and you've just, like, do you get what I'm saying? Walk past, and they've probably been like, you're cool, cuz.
Yeah, but you have to remember as well, I don't know a lot of people. Like,
I know you.
I know people, but people know me.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, man know who Koke is.
Yeah.
They face everything. There's youth that I don't know who they are, and they want to do me something.
Same as me. I'm not going
to. So I got to be on my toes all the time. You get what I'm saying? Even if a fan's looking at me for too long, And his finger, I have to ask, like, are you all right?
Yeah.
Like, are you cool?
And I said, no.
And depending on what he says, it's going to depend on my next actions. Yeah. You get what I'm saying? Yeah. And I've done that my whole career.
Yeah.
Do you get what? Because man's always had war. Man's always been beefing.
Mm.
So I'm paro everywhere I go. I go jail. If you're looking at me too long, you all right?
Yeah.
Depending on what you say is depending on what's going to happen next.
Man, say, no. I love the new Daily Dot because.
I've seen certain man in jail. Mm. I know certain of the youths down there. Before it was all super, super techie. I've been in jail and seen certain man. But I know, man, we've kind of grew up on the same thing, and you're not on nothing with me. You're making it known, Coke, I don't have nothing with you. Like, man, like you, you're cool. All right, cool then. It's cool.
But that's why I spoke on my situation, bro, and I even said, like, do you know, if they knew how much of these men that they think are onto me, see me, or even, I'm not going to blow them up, even DM me, yo, big up for what you're doing, and da-da-da-da-da. And me, I'm a man of principle and morals.
Yeah, but you're,
say that out there, bro.
Don't say
it to me.
Yeah, that's
do
the next thing. I got a bag of man in my DM trying to bear shit, but I can't see you in my comment section.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying?
Go in the comments. Let your brethren know that you're here.
That's how it goes, you get what I'm saying? But in terms of that whole thing there, I think it's just gone way too far for way too long. You get what I'm saying? And it's not within me to... You know what I'm saying?
No, same
it's
as me,
not,
bro.
It's not for me to
same
boom,
as
bam,
me.
Bam. That
I'm not big enough. I'm not big enough to sit down
is,
and
you
say,
get me? That's been
everything.
Going on before I was K Koke.
Yeah.
You know what
yeah,
I'm saying?
Yeah.
That was
See,
going
I didn't
on before
know,
I was K Koke.
And I'm not going to lie to you. Obviously, I've known of the story that I didn't know that.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Like, do you get what I'm saying? Because it's just, it's always been at the height.
Yeah. Do
you get what I'm saying? I don't think there's ever been a stage where it's been like,
but you know, 50. Like Stonebridge, like in Northwest London, Stonebridge is, you got problems with everyone in Northwest London, with most people in Northwest London. Like most ends in Northwest London has got problems with Stonebridge, you get me?
Yeah.
And it's just how it's always been. So it just is what it is, cuzzy. Man's got a role how man's got a role and carry theirself how man carry theirself. You get what I'm saying? Like most of these people that got problems with me don't even know me. They've never met me. They've never probably had a conversation with me. They don't know, man. But because I'm Coke and because I'm the face of the ends, they got an issue with me directly. Do you get what I'm saying? So it just is what it is, cuzzy. It's always been that. It's never been anything less. So I've just been cutting through and doing my thing like I always have. And I'm going to continue to do so. Do you get what I'm saying? If I see people that we got problems with and you got a problem with me, we deal with that there and then. Do you know what I'm saying? But other than that, man's just trying to cut and go through. You feel me?
As usual, man. As usual. Yeah, bro. As I said, like, me, I'm not on the... I don't want you to say anything that might get me 6 extra views or something. No, 100%, bro. Because, like you're my guy.
Yeah.
Like, and I'm gonna put it out there and keep putting it out there. Like, so I don't want to see you upset. I don't want to see you depressed. I don't want to see nothing happen to you.
Yeah,
do you get what I'm saying? So that was just me saying as a overall thing, because I'm not going to front.
I'm a grown man, though. I can speak on any situation with dignity. Like, I'm a grown man. I can keep it 100. And I've always done so. And that's the man, isn't it?
Yeah. No, come on, bro. Because it's like, these things, as I said to you, not to baby food you, not to baby food myself, these things are bigger than me.
Yeah.
I can't talk for the whole of Hackney.
The fact.
Do you get what I'm saying?
I can't talk for the whole of Bridge.
You get what I'm saying? I can't talk for my homies that are in jail for this. I can't talk for my homies that have died. I can't talk for man's mumsies and this, that, and the other. So it's bigger than me.
Fact.
So I was just even when I spoke to my man, it was just like to I don't know, that, as I said, I can only do it with certain man.
Yeah.
So it was, maybe people will say it was a bit of a front, because if you're going to forgive, you better forgive. Forgive all. You get me? Because I can't forgive you and then move to French.
Yeah.
it's not going to make no sense. It's going to be like, right, where was the, do you know what I'm saying? Fact. So it's techie.
Yeah, yeah.
And I get that it's techie.
Yeah.
It's mad techie.
Yeah.
And people don't understand it, because you see the whole, you might see the a Chipmunk and a Bugsy makeup.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm saying?
But that's what I'm saying. Their thing is music beef.
Yeah.
Their thing's a music beef. Man's thing is from the road. This started on the road. This isn't starting music.
Music, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it's a different story.
It's just all, that's all they see.
It's a different story, man. Mm. You know what I'm saying?
No, I get it, bro. I get it, man. I get it. Trust me, I do.
Everyone gets it, man. I know everyone knows what I'm going on. Let's not beat around the bush. Everybody knows. Everybody knows what's going on out here. You get me?
But bro, it makes it more powerful to hear it come out of your mouth.
I hear you.
Do you get it? Because you're not a baby food man in Bridge.
Yeah.
Like, do you get what I'm saying? You're not just the guy that that lived next door to the main man. Like, do you get what I'm saying? At one stage, you went through the stages.
Yeah,
like, do you get what I'm saying? I was a shooter, I was a this, I was a that, I went through all the stages, bro.
Every single stage.
Yeah, bro. And I keep saying to these guys, they skip stages.
Yeah.
A lot of them, and this is why they get caught out and they get found out early.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm saying? Yeah. Man might have a fight today and
That's what I'm saying. Them days there though, to be a rapper and to be big and official, you couldn't skip the stages. Mm. You get what I'm saying? Mm. Everybody, even me, I couldn't listen to a man if he was a dickhead. Mm. That's how I grew up. Do you get what I'm saying? So like, I wanted to know everything about you.
Yeah, right?
You know
even if a man was in America.
Yeah. Everywhere. Yeah. Is he the real deal? Mm. Does he live? Oh, cool, he is. But he's my guy now. Mm. You get me? He's living like man. Yeah. You get what I'm saying, bro? And that's the way it is, cuz. But now it's different. It's different. Man can put on the mask, they can do this and that, and it's just different now. Mm. Just the way it is, you know what I mean? Mm.
So that, like, the whole music, the whole feelings towards it. What are your feelings towards it?
Because
I like the music, but I don't like the people within the music.
Yeah.
And I think they've made, a lot of them make a mockery of people like yourself, bro.
Yeah.
Who really go through the prison.
Who
really go through this. Who really go through the mental. Who really go through the depression time. Depression time. They don't have it.
I have
it, bro.
I know.
Because I'm a real nigga and I got a lot on my chest and I got a lot on my mind. Do you get what I'm saying? You can't do 15, 20 years of work and have nothing on your head. It's impossible.
Back.
Do you get what I'm saying? Back. It's impossible, bro. Like, so...
I think for me, bro, I'm just more focused on keeping my mental straight. I can't watch and worry about what everyone else is doing. And that's my stance on everything. The game's rigged. We all know it. You get me to an extent. You get what I'm saying? Mm. And that's it, bro. I just got to work on me and do me. Like, I know who's real and who's not. I can look at someone and see if you're really that guy. Do you get what I'm saying? Like, we all can to an extent, especially if you're from it. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, like, in terms of all of that, I don't watch everyone, dog. I just do my own thing, and I always have, and I continue to do that, dog.
Facts, I know you don't. I know you don't, bro. I know you don't. You see, when some people say you're in your own world, in your own world.
Literally.
Like, my daughter, my missus, my guy's music. And we'll just go around in the same circle until we get it right. But we're just us. Facts. And if anyone tries to chop into this circle, there's going to be a problem.
I get it, bro.
But, music, the I Ain't Perfect.
Yeah.
Obviously, everyone was going to want to know about that.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm saying? Why is it taking so long?
Bro, I've had this album.
I'm sure we've even gone on about that.
Yeah.
So my answer's in there.
All right. So originally, the whole I Ain't Perfect theme was it's like my little slogan that I've been running with for the time. I was supposed to release that album when I was with Roc Nation. Obviously the deal went sour, that didn't happen. And then I took the time out and I started coming back. But I just felt like, obviously, what did I release? I released Pure Coke Volume 4. I released that. And then I just felt like the next thing after Pure Coke Volume 4 was the I Ain't Perfect album. Mm. The music's new. It's not like music I've been working on from Quay down the line. Half of them songs I don't even like and probably don't even listen to no more. Do you get what I'm saying? So I've started fresh on it. Do you get what I'm saying? And I finished the album. Two years ago I finished the album. And obviously the situation is, and I end up going to jail for this album, innit? Some youths tried to basically hold my album for ransom on some joke thing. The story's mental, and when the case is done, I'll be able to talk on it more. But the youths tried to hold my album for ransom. Man's gone to get it. He's kind of got...
No, bro, you can't say man's going to get it.
Man's going to get it. He's kind of got bashed up on the way out.
Yeah.
And he snitched.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? So I've gone to jail. Done remand, got bail, on tag, and I'm still on tag for it now. So what? I've done 5 months behind the door. Obviously, while I was behind the door, Smalls got killed. Rest in peace, my brother. And then I've got bail. I'm on tag now. So I've been on tag for like 14 months, still on tag, no closer to trial, don't know what's happening. Obviously they're trying to do me for robbery, but how can it be robbery when you're taking your own stuff? You feel me? So obviously that line in the Daily Duppy where I'm saying got me on remand for taking my own shit the album, you feel me? So yeah. But blood, every time I go to release a fucking album, I end up in jail, blood.
Let me release it. Yeah, nah, for real.
If I ever hear you releasing that album,
I'm cutting that off. I'm saying, singles only. Just drop it out as singles.
But right now,
yeah.
Fact, I've got like 3.5 albums. You can.
I've been there. You don't need to tell me. I've heard
you
it.
You get me?
I've heard
like,
it.
Like everyone's in trouble. Everyone's in trouble this year. I believe. Yeah. I'm done breathing down everyone's neck this year. I ain't got no stresses, no worries, no
but
more.
But bro, I'm not gonna. Just as you tapped on it, I'm gonna talk on it. See the small situation, bro.
Yeah.
Because I know, and as I said every time, I know how it is coming from our worlds, bro.
Yeah.
And I know how much that touched you.
But that was my guy, bro. That was my bro. Like, do you get and what I'm hearing saying? It from behind the door, like broke man.
Yeah.
Broke man. Mm. You get me? That was my guy, bro. You get what I'm saying? So,
no, trust me, bro. Trust and they don't understand. I see the smile, but it's not a smiling matter.
Nah, it's not.
No,
but
trust me,
but
I
got nothing but
I
good memories. You get what I'm saying? That's my brother. You get what I'm saying, bro? I love that guy. Mm. You get what I'm saying? And it's, you get me? It's crazy.
Because it
man.
All goes into and everything that I'm saying and why I'm asking these things, bro, because it goes in and it lets people know that it's just not plain and simple for us in music.
Yeah.
For the Egypt boys, it's plain and simple for them. They different. Ain't got a smalls in their life. They ain't got a. They ain't.
I just lost. They ain't been I just lost Lefty as well.
That's what I'm saying. Like, people that I know was close to you.
Like that's big bro as saying? Well. I've just lost like two of my closest within the year. Mm. You get what I'm saying? Gone jail, lost two of my closest. Out on like, obviously I've been through so much now. I just feel like I'm fucking he man. You get me? And I'm stronger. And I'm just cutting through, dog.
But I see that. That you've come through, you're on the other side now.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm
saying? Yeah, I was suffering
before. So am I,
bro. I was suffering
trust me,
before.
Bro. Well, let it out. You got to let them know, bro. Fact. Because
man's
I
got childhood traumas. Man's got road traumas. Man's got fucking, you get me? All kinds of stuff going on in man's life and head. You know what I'm saying? Blood, I've been counselling all of that. I've been, you know what I'm saying?
No.
Trying to get my mental right. You feel what I'm saying?
Mm.
Yeah, big fact. Trust me.
100%.
But man 100%. Has to, bro. If I'm not my best off, I can't be the best self for my family, my daughters or my missus, you know what I'm saying? I can't be my best self if I'm not taking care of those things, you feel me?
And coming from our world, I wouldn't say we baby food it, but we get past and get used to murder. Well, people think we get used to it, but mentally they're stuck in there.
Subconsciously, like, man, don't.
Yeah, but, we don't never.
But in you think you do. Isn't it? Like,
yeah, we do.
My whole life growing up, my friends have been murdered and life. And like, I've got untold amount of friends that I've died to this thing. Do you get what I'm saying? Untold, dog. Probably more than two hands that have died and gone. Do you get me? Not here no more. Man that I grew up with. Do you get what I'm
in
saying?
In the bedroom smoking
and they're not
weed,
here
chilling.
No more. And that's happened over this whole time. Do you get what I'm saying? And you do get used to it. As cold as it sounds, but you do, like, but obviously, do you get me? It still, it really affects, man, dog. It does. You know what I'm saying?
And I saw I kind of saw the stages that it was affecting when I saw you. When I see you not doing music, because I know that's your favorite thing. That's your thing. Do you get me? I'm saying he knows he's as dope as you lot say he is. He's not an idiot. Do you get what I'm saying? So when I see you not doing that, I know you're dealing with the mental.
Yeah, man.
Because sometimes I am. When people are like, Tricky, why aren't you on Instagram? And I'm thinking,
I just cut out whenever I feel like
same
it.
Same as
I'll
me, bro.
I lock my whole Instagram down, deactivated, boom, coke's missing. You get me? I don't give a fuck, lad.
Yeah.
I need to deal with what's in my head right now. And then when I'm feeling all right, I'll pop back in and say, oh, go on.
Yeah.
You get me?
Yeah. Because it's like, it's not, and it's not
nothing's
a thing.
Not worth your mental health, bro, or nothing's not worth, do you know what I'm saying? Like, there's no music, no amount of money that can save none of that. Do you get what I'm saying, bro?
We're from the same hood.
Back.
We're from hoods, bro. So we know that we've seen man come back from everything. From
From being heartbroken. And I've seen man lose it all as well. And go crazy and start burning food. And the man that had it all is the man that's gone now. He's missing. You see him walking down the road like, man, his head gone. And now he's burning food and he's missing. He might as well be dead. You feel me?
And 9 times out of 10, wasn't it the baddest man on the
block? The baddest man on the block.
Yeah, yeah.
The man that was running the block.
He's done a lot.
The first to have all the money. The first to bring the bikes, the cars. The first man to do all of that. And he's missing now. But his mental's gone. Do you get what I'm saying? So, lad, I'm...
that at all costs.
All costs.
Yeah. I know you're deep. I know you're deep, man, anyway. Like, so even when I heard the... what was it? The conspiracy thing.
The conspiracy thing.
What made you do that?
Fam.
Because I know you're a deep guy.
Fam. Blood, look at what's going on around us right now. And I don't care what anybody wants to say, bro. Like, there's some serious stuff going on out here. You get me? And
go deep, but not too deep.
But that's what I'm saying. Like, bro, even I feel like they're shadow banning me right now because of the song. Do you get what I'm saying, man?
is he my guy?
Like... the algorithms, it's all mad. You get what I'm saying, bro? Yeah. But blood, there's some serious stuff going on out here, bro. And I'm a guy, yeah? Like, I've been looking into this stuff a lot from in my earlier ages. You get what I'm saying? And I'm seeing all the stuff that I used to talk about and figure out now is just all coming out. You get what I'm saying? Like, and it's all unfolding in front of me. And I'm a man, I do my research on this stuff. Like, I've got my family, my older cousin, he's on this, you get me? He's the one feeding me all my information. So, bro, I just felt like the energy, what I said in that song, I felt like everyone was feeling like that. Or the people that are around me and the people that message me on my gram and they're all feeling the same as me. Do you get what I'm saying? And I'm looking around and it's like, nobody's not saying nothing. Nobody. What is this, like, are you not just all running with this? We all just gonna take this rushed vaccine that nobody even knows anything about. Like Bill Gates was talking about depopulation not too long ago. You get me? There's a there's a speech of him in a seminar talking about depopulating the planet with vaccines. And now he's the guy behind rolling out all of these vaccines. How does that even make sense for me, bro? How does it make sense for everyone else? Are you not worried about this?
What I thought people thought was the most powerful thing is that you said it. Because remember, rappers stay quiet and they stay humble.
Yeah.
Like, do you get what I'm saying?
Brad, you know me though. If I'm, like I said, no matter how I'm feeling, I felt like I had to say something because I feel like this. I post about it. I'm trying to inform people and give them information about it. So I didn't feel like it was getting anywhere. So I was like, you know what? Like, I might as well make a song about this and do it in a creative way. You see, I got the tinfoil hat on. You get me? So, because everyone has a conspiracy theory, wear tinfoil hats. I put the tinfoil hat on. I'm posting up images and that in the wall, like newspapers, everything, like I'm cracking up. But I'm trying to give people the knowledge. I'm trying to make people go and research and have a look about this stuff. I'm not saying you don't have to
don't listen to me.
Just go and do your research on it at least, because there's people dying from these vaccines. There's people that are permanently disabled. The government have gave these companies they've got immunity. If anything happens to anyone from a vaccine, you can't even sue the company. That alone is raising question marks. You get what I'm saying, bro? But I'll be here forever talking about that stuff. You get me? You get me? They might shut down your thing after that.
Don't worry.
You feel me?
I'll be taking the vaccine, mate.
But blood, you know what I will say though? Everyone, just please, before you lot jump to any conclusions, just go and do your research. Research the companies that's making them. Research the people that own it. Research the people that are promoting the ads, all of it. And you'll see there's a pattern, bro. The same people are behind everything, bro. And it's important, bro. This is not no joke thing, you get me? This is humanity, bro. This is a big thing, depopulation, bro.
You know what you're showing, me, bro, with how you're speaking now, is that my morals, my attitude, my pride, my ego, nothing has changed from the streets. I'm just bringing it here. Do you get what I'm saying? It didn't change in music. It didn't change with what I'm talking about or anything I'm talking about. I run with that. And I run with being me.
I'm me, dog. I'll talk about my gal. I'll talk about my mom. I'll talk about the road. I'll talk about politics, even though I'm not the greatest at it. But however I'm feeling, I'll express myself with it. Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I make music for the people, blood. I absorb the people's energy and I put it out on a record for them. I had to be the people's voice in that situation. Do you get what I'm saying?
No, I know they feel like that now. I know they feel like that now. 100 million percent, bro.
I just hope that other people can start looking into this stuff and talking up as well. But this is a serious situation we're living in right now. God willing, we make it through, man.
No, 100%, bro. 100%. Like, and to have a man like you talking about it is powerful, man. Trust me, and it shows me like your intelligence as well.
Yeah.
100%. I'm not that intelligent to be talking about that shit.
Yeah.
Like, do you get what I'm saying? Like, I'm probably the first.
I'm not the most intelligent, but no, I look into stuff, dog. I read things. I check stuff out, you know what I'm saying, bro?
I'm one of them fucked up niggas, bro. Yeah. Like, I'm straight news. Give me what's on the news and I tell you, bro.
This is the problem, bro.
I'm the problem.
You're part of the problem. Big man thing, you're part of the problem, dog. You get me? Like, people need to really start checking what's going on. You can't believe what's going on the news, bro. You can't, not anymore. Look at what's happening out here, man. You get what I'm saying? They lie about everything. Everything to cover their self.
But bro, you know what it is? And this is me being serious, I'm used to liars. Liars are everywhere.
I know, but
everyone lies.
But now this is affecting our kids' future. This is not just a lie that's gonna Like, this is going to affect how our kids live in the future. And I'm scared for that. You get me? I'm genuinely worried for my youth. I've lived a free-ish life. Do you get what I'm saying? I've been out, I've been able to function how I've more or less wanted to within reason. Right? If this goes true and everything is going to get techie, health passports, like, get me? Like, you can't go places without a vaccine or... it's mental. Let's just move on, because you get me?
Come on, bro. Come on, bro. Don't let it.
I'm blood. This is how passionate and how...
No, I know. I can see
how worried I am about what's going on.
I can see it.
You get
me? I can see it.
Facts.
And all of this, you're adding all of this, bro. So let's, like, how is your mental now?
I'm all right. I'm still struggling with certain things.
No, we do, yeah, bro. Yeah,
and I'm probably never
going
to stop.
I'm cool right now.
Yeah, I'm cool. I'm here. I'm cracking
on. 2 days ago, I just wanted to, people were contacting me on my gram, on my WhatsApp, and I just avoided them. I have them days.
Yeah.
And one of my brethren wrote to me, and I put it up on my Insta. He was like, don't worry, Tricky, I'll get you. You're bipolar. You have days where you don't even want to deal with humans.
Facts.
And I put it out there, genuinely. Facts. Every one of my guys knows this. Like,
I've spent a lot of time alone.
Because you know what it is? We're from the same world, bro. We spent a lot of days coming out and being around 30, 40, 50 man a day. Fiend, if you're going to involve fiends in that, I'm going hand to hand and meeting 100 different people per day. So I think it's a backlash of it to where you just go into your show and you just want to be alone. Yeah, I want to be in my own bubble now. I don't even want, like...
It's hard to... When you're around 40, 50, 60 people a day, it's hard to have a connection with everyone. So you're automatically going to go inside yourself because you can't trust that whole 40, 50, 60 man. You might trust a couple of them, but you're still having relationships with the rest of them. So you're automatically inside yourself anyway. Do you get what I'm saying? In defense mode all the time. I live in defense mode. I have lived in defense mode for a long time. You get what I'm saying? And that's affected
today,
my relationships. Do you know what I'm saying?
With women relationships?
Yeah, with women relationships.
Because
I don't let nobody in.
I don't
feel like no one's ever really loved man. So I don't feel like, you know what I'm saying? Like, bro, she loves man. You know what I'm saying, bro? It's not that. You get what I'm saying? And it's affected my relationship. You know what I'm saying?
In what way would you say it's affected?
I was proper cold. You get me? Like, obviously that's changed now with my missus and that. Like, I've learned my actions and I understand why I used to behave certain. I'm becoming more aware and conscious of who I was and why I used to do certain things and why I am like that now. You get me? So I'm trying to change that and make that different. You know what I'm saying, dog?
Yeah, but it's the effects of it's bringing that life into this life. Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah. And I'm dropping juggling what everything, need to,
yeah,
all in one go.
Yeah, yeah,
this
yeah,
is
yeah,
not
yeah.
like this is not just go to work, come home and do the thing. Like, man, I've never lived that life. I've been on the streets all my life, literally, like from I was like 4 to 5 to 6, I'm outside. I've always been outside, you get what I'm saying? So that's all I know. You get what I'm saying? I'm not used to thinking about anyone else, you get me? Checking in to see if my girl's all right, or I'm not, or like, what, ain't you coming home tonight? Like, I'm not used to that, do you get what I'm saying? Because I've never had to answer to anyone. Do you know what I'm saying? So for me now, it's hard, like, but obviously I'm getting there. You get me? I've been working on it, you feel me?
I suppose the tag helps.
Everyone's locked down.
You coming home, babe? Yes, I'll be home in like 5 minutes.
Yeah,
no, 100%, bro.
You get me? So, yeah, man.
100%, man. But come on, bro. You're my guy, bro. I'm going to keep saying this so they understand that.
Facts, bro.
I've been trying to get you for like 3 years. How many? About 3 years I've been trying to get you to sit down and talk.
Yeah. I wasn't ready them time there. I told you I would only have this conversation with a man like you. Do you know what I'm saying? Like, we're genuinely dogs, so I'm comfortable to have this conversation.
No, because you know I'm not trying to lead you down no garden path, brother, and ask you no stupid questions. And because my thing, bro, has always been, I care for this guy.
Yeah.
Like, no, I really love this guy.
I know
guy.
That as well.
Like, do you get what I'm saying?
You've always kept it one with, man. So, like, I don't ever question it. You know what I'm saying?
Never, bro. Even when I don't put you in the top five, bro, I'm not going to
lie.
No, let me tell you. Let me tell you. Mark does the same thing. But you know what it is?
Same with Mugs. And I'll say the same thing about Mugs.
Do you know what it is? You know who called me on the same day, 5 minutes after each other? You and Spades. And I goes, oh
but
my day.
Spades is my guy,
but bro.
Well. Bro, Spades is 100.
He's 110.
He's another one that man seem to forget about.
Yeah. I've spoken
Spades
about all the time.
One,
I always
bro.
Forget about Spades.
Spades is another one.
But you know
one.
What it is? I forget about the people, and it's easily done. You forget about the people that are just close to you because you think that they're just they're just, you start thinking out of the box.
Yeah, yeah.
You're in my box, bro.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like, do you get what I'm saying? Yeah, like, just to say it, speaking these vaccine terms, you're in my bubble.
Yeah, yeah.
So you're in my bubble. I'm only thinking about, I'm not thinking about no one. I don't think about space. If someone says to me right now, who's your top five artist? Da, 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 da. Because you're here, I'll mention you.
Spades is one of my top five artists.
Yeah.
Fact.
Mm.
Do you get what I'm saying?
Mm.
Cause he had a little error. Like, when that MMP, when all of that started coming out, bro, he had the streets.
Yeah.
There was no doubt about it. You had spades everywhere.
Yeah.
So how can you have a whole moment in time and then people just forget about that? Do you get what I'm saying?
Fickle. Like, we're fickle, bro.
You know what I'm saying?
We're fickle.
Like, but yeah, it is what it is, man.
We're very fickle. Like, as
but you
as
know,
fans.
Like I said, dog, I don't hold feelings. It's not a thing like that. But obviously, I would like the props that I deserve. So yeah, make sure when you lot are doing your next top five, you get me?
Bro, trust me, you're going to hear me say Coke's number one and four.
Yeah.
Like, they're going to be like, right, Tricky, get off his nuts. Like, do you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm gonna be overdoing
facts, though, man. I've like, done a lot for the game,
as I
bro.
Said, bro, I don't like to, before we even cut, I don't want to throw around the legendary status so much that it just looks like man's just throwing it around and you're giving it to, like, I'm not giving it to no grime MC before I give it to you. Do you get what I'm saying? I understand, and everyone's got different legends.
Do you know, do you know when I had my era, grime was not cool.
No, no.
No offense to the grime artists, them, because you're all sick, but
yeah,
when the Coke era was going in, grime was not cool.
Yeah,
wasn't.
Yeah.
Street road rap was what it was.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And then after my team kind of grime came back again.
Yeah.
Facts. Yeah. I had an era, bro.
Yeah.
But the Coke wave was real. It didn't just happen in the UK. Mm. It happened everywhere.
But you get what I'm saying? As I said, if you don't speak about it, no one else is gonna. It's like you just forget, bro.
Yeah, nah,
but as
you,
I was saying, the legendary status can't be thrown about because I know, and I'm not putting, he doesn't do this now, guys, but like, I'm talking from the theft to the robbery to the shootings to the, like, to everything. And this is when it was gun crime.
Yeah,
not bootings.
No, no, no.
Bootings is kind of sugar-coated.
Yeah.
Like, you get me? This was gun crime.
Yeah,
G-U-N.
Yeah.
was mad serious. Do you get me? No, because there's a difference. It's like, I always say there's a difference when someone says bootings, it's kind of sugar-coated. Like, what did a booting happen? When a man said, you know what, a man came with his gun to this place, you know it was that them 93, 95 Stonebridge killers coming.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm saying? 96, that era, like, into the 2000s.
Yeah, yeah.
So, like, you're a legend for that, to me. You're a legend for the music that you've put out. You're, like, the way you've handled it, the way you wear your heart on your sleeve, bro. Do you get what I'm saying? Like, remember, all of our greats have the biggest problems, bro.
Yeah, facts, bro.
Some of our biggest greats, bro. Whoever you want to mention and da-da-da-da-da. And I always touch on the mental side of things because I'm that. I'm you.
Yeah.
You're just me on a bigger scale in the music industry. But I'm thinking, you know what? He's from my world. That man can't do all of that. Well, I know you've done, and I'm not going to say he can't do all of that and go off into the sunset. He literally can't.
Nah, it's not that,
it's
easy,
not that
it?
Easy, bro. It's not that easy. And it lets people know that even the other side of, why not you try and do both?
Yeah,
because a lot of them ain't doing both, and they're pretending that they're doing both.
Doing both.
They're talking about it, but you're not really doing both.
If he was doing both, he'd be struggling like manage. You feel me?
You'll have the remand. Fact. You'll have the boy that wants you. You'll have the shows cut off. You'll have this. You're not really in it. So, and it kind of like, it separates, bro, and it puts me onto that.
I think like everyone in the industry have a responsibility to put these people in their place, bro.
Yeah.
It shouldn't be okay for any Tom, Dick and Harry to just say certain things you're not living. That shouldn't be all right, bro. A man should genuinely pull these people up on that because they're taking it away from the people that are really out here from it, using this as a way to change their life. It's up to people like you doing the podcast and the channels, the people that are really doing this thing and really lived it and come from it. Those are the people you're supposed to push forward and talk about the most, more than these people that are not living it. You get what I'm saying? I don't care how good you can rap, bro. But if you don't live it, talk about what you're living, bro. That's what, you get what I'm saying? Because you're
making a mockery of what I've done.
All right.
And
you
what
get
I've been
saying?
Through.
Exactly.
What my family's been through.
You know what I'm saying,
dog?
You
get what I'm saying? Heart on sleeve business, man.
Trust me.
Yeah, bro. Come on, man. Trust me. It's been emotional.
My
bro.
Brother. Big love, you know. You done, though. Come on, man.
My brother. Come on.